Hey guys, welcome back. Sushil this side, and this is continuation of Power BI tutorial. So as we have discussed in the last video, we have created the dim address table. It's time to create the dim item and dim customer table. So how we can create this? Go to on Power BI desktop, and here, as I told you, we can create the reference or we can create the duplicate. So I am very happy to use the reference. So this time, this is for the customer, so let me rename this with the dim customer. So this is the dim and customer. Now here we just want to get only those columns which are the customer related, so we need to remove other columns. So go to on choose column, and here we can see this is customer ID, then the account number, and then bill to address for those customers. So these three columns will go inside the customer table. So we can click on OK. That looks good. After that, we need to remove the duplicate values. So we can go to on this remove rows, and here we can remove the duplicate. So now we have created the dim customer table. Next, we need to create the dim item table. So how we can create the dim item table? Go to our main table and right click on this and create a reference. And this time, let me call this as dim product. Now, we just want only two columns. First is product ID or product number. Second is product name. So go to on choose column again. And we are expecting only two columns. So here, this is our product name and product number. Now click on OK. It looks good. Now we need to remove the duplicate rows, so we can remove it. It will take few seconds. Now it's done. After that, the product name should be the left column, so we can drag and drop and rearrange the order of the columns. So now it looks good. In the dim customer, customer ID, then the account number, then the bill to address, it is also good. Then dim address table. So finally, we have created the address table, and we have created the item table, and we have also created the customer table. So now there is no need to create this dim date table over here, because in the Power BI we are having an option directly to get the date, year, quarter, month and day. So there is no need to create this dim date table. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe my channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. Thank you so much.